Sunday, there will be no more Victory Warriors clubs available. So if you want a Victory Warriors club, you must get it in the mail today, or you must have it postmarked by June 15th. And after the park opens, there will be no more silvers and lifetime combinations. That means you can still stay in the tower for 4 days and three nights the rest of your life. Plus, you get a free silver club that uses this water park. You use the, every year you have a marvelous workshop free of charge. You have the, as I said, all the different activities. All non-food events are free at Heritage USA. So if you want a Victory Warriors, you need to get on your phone today. We've opened up a few more. What we've done over here on this tower, we've added two more floors of rooms to the Heritage Grand Towers. And so lifetime members will have two more, and that crane's moving right now. I see it as we're moving up now. Let's see, we're going to the 14th floor right now of the 21-story Heritage Grand Towers. And all the memberships will be closed out. We've opened two more floors, plus something special that I can't tell you about. But it's a special bonus for all lifetime members that is going to be something you're going to be thrilled over.
Have you told me yet?
No.
Oh, dear.
I'll tell you, though, privately.
Okay, whisper it to me later.
Next Monday, the lifetime memberships will be, there will be no more lifetime memberships, but the Silver Club will be $1,000. So right now, for a $500 gift, you receive a Silver Club, or $500 gift, you receive the lifetime membership, which that room would cost that much down at Orlando at the Marriott or all. You would actually pay that much for one three-night and four-day visit. So be sure to get it in the mail or call us and help us to finish this miracle. We're going to see this miracle completed. What happened to my Bible that was sitting here?
We got it right here.
The Lord has been speaking to me about finishing this park this month. And the Word of God says, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain." Or in the Living Bible, it says, "So run your race to win." You know, at PTL, we have been satisfied with not really meeting our goals. We have had telethons, and we wouldn't quite make it. And then we'd slip back. Then the next year, we wouldn't quite make it. And we carried a load of debt, like a dead man's bones, on our back for all these years. So we were always trying to catch up, always trying to catch up. And we had a telethon, and 60% of our calls were fake and phony pledges. They were crank calls. And, you know, most of the time you just say, well, let's just go on and try to make it. But 2 weeks ago, God gave us one of the biggest miracles I've ever seen on a weekend. And calls begin to come in. Those Victory Warriors, $1,000 gifts, begin to come in. And all we were trying to do was raise enough to make $1,000 or $1 million payment on that building. Instead, God is enabling us to actually pay the building off up to what's there and pay $8 million instead of $1 million, plus to pay all of our TV stations, plus to pay all of our other bills. And now God's going to help us to pay all of those high interest rate loans and notes that we've been carrying. I believe God has said enough is enough. And I believe now is the time for total victory. So run your race to win. And that's why we've opened up the Victory Warriors, because the people we gave to last Friday to get their pledge in, some did not do it. Some did not, their credit cards didn't go through. And others just didn't write. And I've made up my mind, and I believe God has spoken to my heart, don't give up, Jim, until the miracle is full. We must complete this miracle now. And if you want to be a part of I think you get back $1 million heritage for your gift of $1,000 to be able to stay in this beautiful place in your beautiful room for 4 days and three nights every year the rest of your life, as long as one of you live, the husband or wife, and then your children. Even if your children are 150 years old and you're 200 years old, as long as one of you are alive, your living children, your children, the dead ones wouldn't come probably anyway, but can use this the rest of your life. Isn't that something? And then the silver benefits are free for those who join. lifetime membership up until this Sunday. So it's exciting, and we're going to finish this race. Because here in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, it says, I want to suggest that you finish what you started to do a year ago. For you were not only the first to propose this idea, but the first to begin doing something about it. You know, we're the first Christians to ever have a wave pool. We're the first Christians to ever build a water park. We were the first to propose such a thing. The newspapers came and said, what does this have to do with Christianity? I said, the Bible says we're fishers of men, and this is the bait. I want to tell you, the teenagers aren't going to camp meetings, but they're coming to Heritage Amen. USA. And we're witnessing to them. We're teaching them about Jesus. We're helping them to get off drugs. We're putting marriages back together again. Christians are total people. That's what it's all about. Well, having started the ball rolling so enthusiastically, you should carry this project through to completion, just as gladly giving whatever you can out of whatever you have. Let your enthusiastic idea at the start be equaled by your realistic actions now.
Amen.
Let's finish this miracle.
Amen.
Let's finish Kevin's house. Let's finish the farm. Let's finish all of Heritage USA and give the devil a black eye. They can build casinos and gambling houses all over the land. Let's build this place for the glory of God. And get on the phone and call today or write and become a victory warrior. I'll tell you, you'll never regret it. If you could climb through these mountains and these islands and up and through this place and see the tube rides down the mountains and see all of it, you won't believe what you see back up in there. It is unbelievable. So be a part of it, okay? Tammy Faye, before we talk to Danuta and Kai, why don't you sing us a song, okay?
Okay, Jim, I'm going to sing our theme song, Don't Give Up on the Brink of a Miracle. And I'm glad that you didn't give up, baby.
Thank you. I'll tell you what, sometimes it's the hardest on the wife or the mate when you go through the battles in the valleys. And Tammy Faye, I think, is as impressed with this water park as anybody, and that makes me happy. Because this yesterday was the first time she's seen it since it's neared completion. And I got a feeling she was just a tad overwhelmed with it, which I think we're all a bit overwhelmed with what's happening. And as we add the palm trees later on today, I think it's going to take on quite a tropical paradise look for all of God's people. You know, a few months ago, we almost gave up on this island. We had so many problems with it. It just seemed like it wasn't going to work. And then our people came in here and began to finish this island. And now we're just hours away from opening Heritage Island, Heritage USA. Don't give up. Don't give up on the brink of a miracle. Tammy Faye, sing it for us.
Dare give in, your God is
Oh, that's great.
That was my fault, not theirs.
You almost gave up on the brink of a miracle.
I almost gave up on the brink of a miracle.
Tammy's just undergone surgery, and she's still weak from it, and this hot sun is unbelievable. I have with me Ray Sibley. Is that right?
That's right.
Ray is the owner of Calco Coating Company. How did a lady get into unbelievable company like coating massive pools and water parks like this?
Well, you start small on bathtubs and spas, and you work into large things like this. And what a thing this is, huh?
Isn't it beautiful?
Gorgeous. I'm so pleased to be a part of it. Really am.
You know, you're kind of a you-can-make-it lady to have a company. You know, they tell me that you're the number one pool coating company in the world, that anybody who wants the best always calls Ray. Why is that? Why do you think that they want you to do their pools? What makes you different than the rest of them?
A lot of hard work, I suppose. A lot of hard work. And I have a lot of people that help me out, too. Got Pam Manny that I brought out here, and Kim Kaiser and Bob Templin, and a lot of hardworking people behind me.
So how many ladies do you have on your staff, then?
There's five.
There's five ladies?
Yes.
And I understand that sometimes some of the men are a little chauvinistic, and you've even been turned down for park jobs because they said, well, a woman couldn't do that's too big of a job.
Well, sometimes that happens, yeah. But once we get on the job, we don't have any problem.
You've worked some days until, what, you've almost dropped 16 hours?
Yeah, that's right. We've kept plugging away, and God willing, we've got it done out here. We've set a record on this park. We got it done under 3 weeks now.
Are you proud of it?
Oh, yes. Very proud. Very proud.
It's a beautiful birthday. Thank you, Ray. God bless you. Appreciate it. Ray Sibley, I just been wanting you to meet some of the people. I don't know where my cameras are. There's so many cameras out here. Where would you like me to look? I just wanted you to meet some of the people that have made this thing happen, because without the team like Ray Sibley and the people that have worked here, and Jimmy Barger from the Pacific Pool Company, Pacific Pools, I want to tell you, so I'll give them a plug. If you ever want a swimming pool, don't call anybody but Pacific Pools. These people understand the pool business, and what a job they're doing building these rocks and building these pools. It has been fantastic working with them. And, you know, last week I mentioned we needed some fiberglass people on these slides. We weren't going to be able to get the slides open on time. So I put out a SOS. Somebody in California heard me put out the SOS, called their family in, what was it, Hilton Heads, South Carolina, and Warren and Matthew, I can't read that far, Paul, you're going to have to come closer. I don't know their last name. Warren and Matthew Andrews are up there on the, what we call the typhoon right now, and they've come in from Hilton Heads, South Carolina to help me finish these slides. It's very delicate work, very hot work, working with fiberglass and 125 degree down in those slides. And they're from the Marine Finishers of Hilton Head, South Carolina, Warren and Matthew Andrews. And they have worked until they've almost dropped. And but what a job and what a slide we're going to have. I tell you, our seams are better than our slides even. That's how good people are doing, because they want the best and the safest slides for our partners. And I want to thank Charlie Brown. Charlie Brown and his wife have been working from INR. They're from York, South Carolina. They're right here. He was kidding me about, I said I'd fly anybody free that helped me with these slides from anywhere in the world, Eastern Airlines. And so he said, well, where's my free airplane ticket from York? Well, York is in this, the York County's right here. In fact, Heritage USA, part of it's in York County. And so I want to thank Charlie Brown and his team and his wife and all of them that have helped us there. And Charlie Brown's been working on these serpentine slides over here. And from PTL, I want to thank Bob Dart and, oh, there's too many. I better stop mentioning all the names. But Roger Garrett, who's been, and all the construction crew here, we'll meet some of them as the days go on. But you must give credit where credit is due. You must do that, because you couldn't make this big of a miracle take place without a lot of people. And so many of the supervisors and people have been working 16-hour days to make this thing work for us. By the way, if you like to swim and you'd like a job as a lifeguard this summer, we're going to need about 150 lifeguards now, they tell me. So we can open two shifts a day. So if you're out there and you're a good swimmer, we'll teach you and help you to become certified. And you'd like to help work on this island, it takes 75 guards a shift to run Heritage Island. So get a hold of our personnel office at 1-704-542-6000. And the extension number is too far away for me to read. I can't read that card. It's probably on your screen. Ask for personnel when you call, okay? We'd appreciate that. Howard and Vestal are going to sing a song for us. And we hope that you all will come and visit us at Heritage USA, that you're going to be a part of this great new victory. On the July 4th is the official grand opening of Heritage Island. Next Saturday, our pre-opening, we'll be opening on a limited basis daily, probably 8 hours a day for the next 2 weeks, starting this Saturday. And to get it all everything worked out and all the bugs worked out, you know, and get the lifeguards, they've been training for weeks and months, some of them. But they need to kind of open on a little slower pace and up until the 4th of July. 4th of July will be grand opening, but we'll be opening on a temporary kind of basis. Lord willing, and the state gives us our permits, we'll open this Saturday, and we're going to have an exciting time here at Heritage Island. We hope that you'll be a part of it. Don't forget, if you want that silver and lifetime combination for a one-time gift of $1,000, there's only a few days left. You better call right away and say, I want a partnership, because there will never be another lifetime in the towers after this. So come on down and help us, okay? All right. Howard and Vestal, couple beachcombers. He keeps lifting me.
And he does.
What? Are they testing the waves?
Oh, the waves.
Oh, there is a little waves. Well, they're just testing each unit. Yeah, we'll check them out. They got excited. Their waves started rolling. It is. We got a white cap here, isn't it? Well, we'll watch it and see. Praise God. He keeps lifting me higher.
Facing decisions with answers unknown.
Didn't know what to do.
A valley with no end inside. But I stepped out in faith, believing that I soon would be receiving what he promised to make of my life.
Persecuted, cast down, but remember.
marvelous? We made some waves. Well, there's a duck
there's a duck in the pool.
That's that duck that's a ham. He was waiting for the water, and here he is back.
Can you believe that? He's been waiting for days, and he's back.
That duck has sat in that pool 2 days waiting for the water.
That is so cute.
They're already starting to test the wave devices. This thing will make unbelievable waves, and I don't know if they're going to be able to do it while we're on the air today, but by tonight, they expect to have the wave machine working fully and in its final test. Isn't that nice water?
Oh, it's wonderful.
The water will be perfectly blue when it's balanced, when the chemicals are balanced. It will turn beautifully blue. We have to vacuum it. This is just getting in now. We have another 12 inches higher yet to go on the... We have 14 underwater cameras, and those boys are out there playing with them right now. Come on back, Tammy Faye.
I could cool off a little bit. The sand is hot.
Oh.
Oh, fun.
Well, we're so excited about this. Danuta, Kai, it's so nice to have you here.
Thank you. Boy, I got to tell you, this is our first time here, and what an experience this has been.
It's been absolutely delightful.
It's been terrific. I really love it.
What an exciting day for you guys to come on.
I really, really love it. And Tammy, I used to be a swim instructor.
Yes.
And
really?
I could teach a rock to
float. She's going
to teach me to swim. Would you like a job?
I'm going to
be a lifeguard.
I used to be a lifeguard as well, but I could teach you to swim like that.
Could you? Well, we'll do it.
Over a weekend.
We will do it.
Right now.
Not right now.
If you want to learn how to ski, she'll teach you that too.
Oh, no, you ski too.
Danuta, I wanted to ask you a question I think everybody wants to know. How did you end up on the 700 Club from California? Maybe I should go back a little bit further and find out how you found the Lord first, perhaps. But I think people like to know more about you.
Well, it's a story that still has me reeling from it myself. But when I met my husband, Kai, he became my best friend. And at the time, I was looking for that reality in life. You know,
yes.
I had everything else I needed. I had my education. I had a career that was going very well in broadcasting in Southern California. And at the merry old age of 33, I looked at everything and I said, is that all there is? It was a tough road to get what I needed to make myself happy. And so I had my condominium on the beach, and I had my little yellow Porsche, and I had my friends, and I had my television job, and I thought, so what? I mean, if that's all there is, then I think I'd rather cash it in. And I wasn't depressed, but I had a very intellectual thought of suicide, actually. I was thinking to myself, why should I get up in the morning?
Yeah.
Why should I brush my teeth, go down that little ribbon of highway every day to work and come back? What significance do I have to the Milky Way? And I couldn't fathom why. And so my best friend at the time introduced me and the philosophy group that I was involved with to somebody called Harold Bredesen. And Harold Bredesen is a dear man. Yeah, Harold struck hard in my life. And Harold Bredesen led me to the reality of Jesus Christ.
Isn't that something?
And it was after that meeting with Harold, with the entire philosophy group, we all met the Lord Jesus Christ that night and became a Bible study group.
Isn't that tremendous? Really? That Harold Bredesen has absolutely entered more people's lives, like people like Pat Boone and Mr. High adventure man and
symbolist.
And I mean, he is just absolutely, and he goes to the places, the Tiffany's and all these people, and goes to meet him and doesn't fear a thing. He's like a prophet. And here he's in your life. I didn't know that. He's one of my dearest friends, and yes. I know he's a member of the board, I believe.
Well, I call him Dad. He's my spiritual dad. And in fact, it was Pat Boone's book, A New Song, that had Kai looking for Harold in the first place.
Did you know the Lord before you met?
I met the Lord in 1957. It was only a lukewarm relationship. And I read about Harold Bredesen in a book called A New Song by Pat
yes,
Boone.
Yes.
And I was in Sweden at the time. And I decided to go looking for Harold Bredesen and find the men who had the fullness of God in their life. And I found him eventually, and eventually that led to, well, 5 days after I met Bredesen, I in turn also met Danuta 5 days later.
And then 5 years later, he introduced me to Harold Bredesen. But it has been a long roadmap. But during two very intensive first years as a Christian, during which I was in a very urgent Bible study. I mean, now yes. The philosophy group, these ex-philosophers are now born-again Christians. And we didn't just sit there in Bible study going, amen and hallelujah, and isn't that wonderful? We got almost hostile. It was like, show me, prove it, yeah. Why,
right.
How?
Right.
I mean, the minute we put our faith aside, I mean, we put our intellect aside, then we had to say, all right, we accepted Christ by faith, now give me back my intellect and let me satisfy that as well. And it was a very rambunctious Bible study meeting. In fact, the pastor, Pastor Coleman Phillips, who mastered the Bible study for the five of us, later confessed that every Tuesday night he would pray to God and say, oh Lord, do I have to?
Do I have to face the lions again,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah. But it was a series of dreams that some people had about me. My co-host for my television show in California had a dream, and he said, I never dream. He's a Jewish man. He said, I never dream. I never remember my dreams if I did. And he said, I dreamed you were on a national television show for Jesus Christ. Huh? And I said, oh, you've got to be kidding. Because I thought I was going to a secular network. Uh-huh. And it was then that 2 days later, I'm laying on a sandy beach much like this. And a lady comes up to me and she says, excuse me, you don't know me, but I see your show. And my husband, who never dreams, had a dream about you last night. And she said, we're Jewish, you know. And I said, not another Jewish dream. And she said, you know, he was climbing a staircase to see a religious leader, and you are standing there instead of a rabbi. And she said, what are you doing in my husband's dream? And what are you doing at the top of the stairs? Are you studying to become a rabbi? And I said, no, I'm just struggling to be a good Christian. And
had you met Pat yet at all? Had you known
no.
Pat Roberts?
You
had
see,
you watched the 700 Club?
The 700 Club was on the same time my show was on.
Oh, your competition.
Yeah, we were on competing channels and competing networks. So I had never
So you
seen
weren't it. Even really why weren't
no.
hardly aware of the 700
no,
Club.
No, I wasn't. And it was then that Harold Bredesen called me the next day and said, you ought to send a tape of your work and a letter with the dreams in it to CBN. And he explained what CBN was. I sent the letter simply because I love Harold and not expecting anything from it. And I know what a resume is, but I never sent dreams with it, you know. And I didn't hear from them for 9 months until finally they are about to throw out an old desk that they are cleaning out. And they come across a letter that was never opened and a videotape that was never looked at until minutes before they called me. And they said, we've been looking for somebody like you for a long, long time. And I said, did you say this was CBS calling? and they said, we'd like you to become part of the 700 Club. And I said, what's the name of the show?
Uh-oh.
And they said, it's the 700 Club. And so it was on my birthday, 2 years in the Lord, and it was on my birthday that I packed up my African violets and my calico cat and said goodbye to the only home I'd really ever known and left my friends behind and went to Virginia Beach, Virginia to do God only knew what. And it was during those times I thought, why? God must have made a very big mistake. He really must have made a tremendous error, because I am here between these two spiritual giants, Ben Kinchlow and Pat Robertson, and here is this little blonde Polish person, 2 years in the Lord. And I thought, every morning when I drove to work, my prayer was, oh God, don't, just one more day, Lord, don't blow my cover.
That's wild.
But it's been 5 years now, and there's been a tremendous sense of satisfaction, and I know the Lord hasn't made a mistake, although I still pray that prayer pretty frequently.
Well, Danuta, you do a great job.
Thank you,
You
Tammy.
Do a wonderful job. We're proud of you.
Thank you so much.
Tammy always says that women will not watch a program without another woman
on. They won't. I don't think women will watch a program.
And she was thrilled when Pat finally got a woman on his show. Okay, let's go on just a little bit. Kai, your name is so unusual. It sounds Hawaiian.
Well, it really is Hawaiian, even though I was born and raised in Sweden. But a missionary went to Hawaii and thought the blue sky, the beautiful waters, was something they ought to import back to Sweden, where it usually is like the weather in North Dakota. And I, in turn, was named simply Kai because it means ocean in Hawaii.
Oh.
Just like you have your wonderful swimming pool with the waves coming about here soon. And I have enjoyed living in this country tremendously. I love living here. And, of course, the joy of meeting Danuta. And
you used to sing, didn't you?
I used to be an entertainer in Sweden. I was a well-known entertainer over there. And then I have been a businessman over here. But I still sing and play a lot.
Nice. Yes.
Yeah, for the glory of God these days.
Next time you come back, I want you to sing.
Yeah, that's a promise. I'll be glad. If I can use your band, that is.
Yes, you can use the band.
I mean, that is beautiful.
Yeah, it'd be fun.
Wonderful musicians.
They are great. When your cameraman was going after the duck out there, they were playing the theme song from Jaws.
You've written a book. I have a copy of it. In fact, I had one of the first copies, I think. Forgot who sent it to me. One of the publishers, I think, or one of the writers told me I would really enjoy the book. What's the book about? First of all, I know, but I want you to tell me.
Well, it's called Dear Danuta, and as you know, you get thousands and thousands of letters from people with thousands and thousands of problems.
Yes.
And people with thousands and thousands of ideas, and I started to see these letters come in categories, you know, family problems, how do I meet Mr. Right, and then people who always wanted to comment on the clothes I wore, or how my hair looked, or what I'm doing with my makeup, and I would get people saying
you
things like...
You get that too?
Oh, yes. I would get people
I'm
calling...
I'm so glad!
I get people writing to me and say, why don't you dress more like... the girl on the Today Show, and why don't you wear peach? You look much better in peach. And then somebody else will write and say, don't ever wear peach again. That is not your color. And then we get letters from people who are in real pain. And so I wrote the book almost like a Christian Ann Landers type.
Yeah.
And gave some of the answers. These are real answers to real letters with real problems. And it's been some help to a lot of people.
What do you think about woman's lib?
Well, I'll tell you. I think it had great intentions. I think the idea of a woman being a significant contributing factor to society, to government, to the family, to world opinion was a wonderful idea. The problem was, I think they went way, way, way too far. And even now, they're admitting that they have done that. Betty Friedan,
yes,
who is the mother of feminism, has even come out with a subsequent book 20 years later and called The Second Stage. And she says, ladies, we've gone too far.
Huh.
And now she says we have to swing the pendulum back because they were trying to make women super. And if you can't be everything, you end up feeling worse than had you even tried.
You know, I've been in the church all my life, but I've been in the ministry 25 years. I've met the most liberated women in all the world are Christian women.
Yes,
they're
liberated.
Tammy.
That's right.
I mean, if Tammy got any more liberated, we couldn't handle it. I mean, you know, Danuta, you're liberated. You're doing something that I think a lot of ladies would dream about doing. And Vestal sitting down here, God knows she's liberated. We've been trying to get her a little back in herself a little bit there. But, you know, it's marvelous that, you know, the Bible says that you can do all things through Christ. And God's in
and
the
Jim,
last
the Bible
days especially.
Says, and the Bible says, whom the Son has set free is free indeed. And we as Christian women, our freedom comes from Jesus.
Yeah.
And knowing him.
Well, you know, we have a spiritual freedom that is very, very real. And I think there must have been a time, especially during the 60s, when we lost, and when I say we, I'm in that generation, uh-huh. and as you probably are too. And you know that we lost, for those of us who didn't know the Lord then, lost touch with ourselves, lost touch with that spiritual part of us. And when you lose touch with your spiritual man, you are suddenly only a physical man, an emotional man, but not a spiritual man. And so you're like a wounded duck.
Yes.
And you try to replace that with some, you think, well, there's some area in me that isn't fulfilled yet. There's some area in me that hasn't been satisfied yet. And not realizing that it's a spiritual need, you try to fill it up with a self-esteem.
Yeah, that's right.
And you try to find an identity other than a spiritual identity. And you lose that way.
You know, Danuta, when you said that you had done everything, you were 33 years old and had done everything. And yeah. You said, is this all there is? Oh, my heart. That was such a familiar cry, you know. Is this all there is? And, you know, in the world, that would be all there was. Mm-hmm. That would be all there is. But when you know the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior, as the song Vestal sings, He keeps lifting you higher and higher. There's higher goals and higher heights to obtain when you know the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior.
That's right. That's right. You know, I took transcendental meditation thinking that that might be the something that I was looking for.
Uh-huh.
And I paid the guru $300 to get my mantra. And I sat there oming myself into oblivion. And 3 months later, my guru says, how is it going? And I said, you know, I've really been looking for something. And he said, what did you find? And I said, I found my nothingness. And he said, that is the mystery of it all. He said that something is nothing.
Oh.
But I found that,
to learn that
God can take nothing and make something out of it.
Amen.
Amen.
Is it true they're considering drafting you for Vice President of the United States? Is there any truth to that rumor?
I'm still prayerfully considering that, brother.
You mean we have another Vice President?
We have yes.
Another one.
Yes. Tammy Faye has been drafted, and now Danuta, the rumor is that she's going to be running for vice president.
So you saw here first, folks.
So these women will be slugging it out in the political arena.
You want to talk about liberated.
Things must be kind of buzzing around CBN these days.
It's exciting. It's exciting times. It's exciting times when you can see Christians becoming politically powerful. Because when precinct delegates, these are the people that start the ball rolling, these are the grassroots, right? These are folks in neighborhoods. Yeah. When they start mobilizing, as they did in Michigan, they can literally turn the political climate around and say, we're not nobody.
That's right.
We're not powerless. That we can make changes because we are doing it now. And that is exciting.
Right. If you're a living, breathing American, I want to tell you something. If you want to run for president, you have that right in America. And I believe that born-again Christians are not second-class citizens. And, you know, somebody said, well, you can't build a water park. Well, here it is, folks. We can do all things through Christ.
That's right.
And that is the presidency or the mayorship or the governorship or whatever. I believe that it's time that Christians say, enough is enough.
That's right.
We will overcome, as someone went before us to say. The PTL Singers, sing for us. The Army, the Lord. Come on, folks, let's take back what the devil's taken from us.
Oh, we're walking into the enemy's camp, laying our weapons down, shedding our armor as we go.
Don't realize that the captain of the There's no place to hide. Our shields of faith are full of darts. They're coming from every side.
Just shake off the darts, run right at them, and remember who you're fighting for. Don't fall asleep, cause if they catch you, they'll tag you prisoner of war.
Are we walking into the enemy's camp, laying our weapons down, shedding our armor as we go?
When they laid their armor down, because it's not by might,
not by power, but by my spirit,
saith the Lord. People, you're on the winning team. Stick with God. Jesus Christ is the victor that overcomes the world. Thank God. Well, our time is gone for today. By the way, if you want to read more of the comments of Danuta Soderman, you can get her book, Dear Danuta.
Jim, co-host, that's a great book.
It's Revell, by the way.
I highly recommend it.
Thank you. It's good, wonderful,
down-to-earth answers to Danuta.
I know why you like reading, because it's all those letters. Women like to read other people's mail, I think. But it's fun to read other, it's fun to read letters. It always, that's why people like Ann Landers. Well, they always wonder what other people are saying.
Well, I was very fascinated by Danuta's really wonderful answers.
Yeah. In fact, we like you, Danuta.
Yes, we do.
You know, I like you, too. And I'm shocked.
So do
I. This is such a treat.
And we met you in Washington, and, you know, when you see somebody on television, you always say, I wonder what they're going to be really like.
Yeah.
And,
Well, they'd be as nice as they seem. That's what I always say. Oh, I hope.
And you were nicer than we thought you would even be, you know.
This has been, well, we really have been, this feels like we're on vacation. I mean, please bring us back here
because
this is a wonderful vacation. And Tammy, you and I can go down the slide after I teach you to swim.
Okay, all right. We'll do it.
We'll do it.
And tell Pat we love him.
Yes, we do.
And we're standing with
him. I'll bring your blessings.
Our time's gone for today. Thank you for being here with us. It's so neat to have Danuta here and Kai, and I hope they'll come back and be with us again. And Kai's going to sing the next time he comes back. And it's just nice to have the fellowship of the 700 Club and PTL Club and all the ministries, the way they love each other today. There's such a move of God among the leadership and among God's people today. I believe it's the prayer of Jesus that he prayed that we'd be one. Goats may be budding around, but the sheep are getting together. Thank God. Well, remember, the final day for the Victory Warriors is Sunday, June 15th. There absolutely can never be another Victory Warrior Club after that. But let's fill in the gap and make up the hedge and call us or write us today if you want that $1,000 lifetime silver and tower membership together. We got two extra floors for you. God loves you. He really does. Bye-bye for today.
Weekend, we're going to put PTL over the top in a great victory celebration that in